The defense closed its case on Tuesday in the Willie Kimani murder trial, setting the stage for closing arguments early next year. The four AP officers suspected of the murder put on spirited attempts to clear themselves in the 2016 brutal killings. However, the most shocking moments came up this week, when a civilian revealed how he was used by officers to commit the crime. Kimani, who was a lawyer working with International Justice Mission, was brutally murdered alongside his client Joseph Atwenda and taxi driver Joseph Muaruri on June 23. They were abducted as they left Mavoko Law Court and their bodies recovered a week later at Oldenio Sabuk River. The defense hearing was marked with shocking revelations from police informer Peter Ngugi, who gave detailed accounts of how the crime was committed and went further to say how he was bribed last month with SH15,000 by Frederick Laliman to keep silent. Ngugi, who claimed to have been recruited by flying squad officers in 2009, confessed how he was paid SH3,000 by police officers from Lolongo Police Station to spy on the victims while they were in court and later handed them over to their killers. He said he took charge of their taxi and abandoned it in Lamuru before he reunited with the officers later that night at a deserted field in Soweto area in Lolongo. It is at this field that the victims were brutally murdered before their bodies were stashed in gunny bags and transported in the middle of the night to the river. In his recent confession to court, Ngugi said he did not know how the three were killed, a contradiction of his earlier confession to police in which he gave a chilling account of how each of the three were murdered. The prosecution presented 46 witnesses, some who testified in camera and others who were the last people to see and talk to the three men before they were killed. The prosecution also used high technology to prove its case, including phone data analysis, cell site analysis and car recognition cameras from C3, Command Control Center. They also relied heavily on a police radio phone believed to have been with Laliman on that night, DNA evidence of cigarette butts and swabs taken from Ngugi, and a tissue paper said to have been written by Willie while he was at Siokomau Police Post. It was after the testimonies of the prosecution witnesses that the judge placed Laliman and Ngugi on their defense. Other accused persons facing trial are Leonard Mwangi, Stephen Kiburet, and Sylvia Wanjiku. By wrapping up their defense yesterday, the prosecution and defense lawyers will proceed to write and exchange their final arguments. Thereafter, Justice Jessie Lessett will issue a judgment and later sentencing, if she finds the accused guilty. Justice Lessett yesterday directed the prosecution and victims' lawyers to file and serve their submission by January 17, 2021.